Hello YouTubers. So in this video what I want to do is basically summarize my findings with all my videos that I uploaded where I was testing the resolution and the format. I basically did this because, as you know, I mean, a lot of my reviews are done on multimeters, and I do plan to do a review on the watches that I've collected over time. I'll just quickly show you in front. I've got a few watches which I've collected for different reasons, and I thought some of you might find that interesting why I've actually done that. So for that reason, I wanted good video quality up on YouTube, and basically something that showed really, really good detail. I know for myself personally, if I go and look for an item that's been reviewed and I'm looking at either photographs or video, I really, really want to see high quality for myself, to see, i.e. if the plastics, just the general detail of the product up front are what I'm looking for, besides what the person's telling me. And obviously the one way to do that is to be able to get a nice close-in shot, good high quality, that can show you that. I mean, for instance, when I zoom in close to either the Fluke multimeter or, for instance, into like the Seiko watch that I had on there, you are seeing detail which I can't even see with my own eye with the item in front of me. You'll get to see far more. So that's the reason for wanting to get the nice camera boom. I've still got, there's an update to the camera boom project. I need to eliminate the shake, mount it more firmly, sort out the lighting. So basically these things pop. When I talk about the good quality plastic on something, you can actually have a good close-up look and see the plastics and whether they're good or not. Anyway, so I'll just quickly show you how I made my decision. And again, I thank a lot of you for your inputs and what you've said. And when I go through kind of my process and how I made my decision, if you've got any comments you want to make, whatever, then please do post them. Okay. So basically on the screen here, what I want to show you is I've gone and opened up four of the videos that I uploaded. I'm not going to open up them all of them now, because I'll probably bore you to tears. But I've opened them up each in their own tab, and I've allowed the video to load to a certain point. I've actually set them all, for this example anyway, and you can go do this for yourself, I've set them to stop at about 12 seconds. Just so we can do a fairly like-for-like comparison. Now, when I say a fairly like-for-like comparison, because these are at, I don't know how many frames per second we're getting out of YouTube, you're not going to be seeing exactly the same frame, but it's the closest thing you can get to kind of do a reasonable comparison between the video. So the first one I've got up there, and the reason, so what I did was open them up in their own tabs. Make sure you select the highest resolution available from YouTube, and then select the kind of, not full screen, not minimal, but the medium size video. Because then what you can do, you can switch between the tabs and have a close look. I'm switching right now, and have a close look at the detail of the video and what have you. So I'll just go through what I did and what I saw and what kind of made me finally choose the resolution and format. So I'm going to start off, this is the WMV 1280 by 720p, and straight away I noticed with the, and this is talking about the formats, the WMV, the black, the grey, the colours and the blacks and the contrast was muted. I mean, the blacks to me almost look grey. I don't know if you're going to see it in this video, but I switch flick between the two. But there's definitely a far better color contrast and what have you. So immediately for me, that throughout the WMV format, and that's also thanks to, and I apologize, I forget the viewer's name that made the suggestion, I should consider MPEG-4. But then I then also realized that obviously to get the detail I wanted, I couldn't upload at 720, I needed to go at 1080. So then it was a choice between AVC and MPEG-4, and to my eye, flicking between these two, and I'm doing that now, I could not see any real difference in terms of the quality and the resolution. So the easy deciding factor there was, the next thing to fall back to was the file size, and the file size of the MPEG-4 video was smaller. And because our bandwidth in South Africa isn't that brilliant, that's a biggie for me. So the smaller file size of both uploading, the amount of space that's going to consume on my hard drive and for backups is important, because at the moment, see, I'm doing several videos a week. I'm going to chew through hard drive space. Okay, so that put me to the MPEG 4. Then what got me, and again, you can, if you pull the, and I won't do it on that one as I'm showing you, if you pull back to the font and have a look at the font of the intro screen, it looks a lot softer than it does for me locally after I was uploading it to YouTube. And that's what pushed me to playing around with the sharpening filter on Sony Vegas Studio. And literally, again, you'd have to go and probably do this for yourself, but I can tell just by clicking between the MPEG 4 1920 by 1080p and the MPEG 4 1920 1080p sharpen, it is a lot crisper. It's just amazing what that sharpening does. And it's not so much what the sharpening does. Basically, the picture ends up being over sharp, but it gets dulled down when it gets uploaded to YouTube. So at least you're kind of catering for some of the loss in the crispness after it goes to YouTube. And I certainly noticed that when I was looking at the writing on either the multimeter, or in particular, if you go to like 1 minute 40 in the video, and I'll just pull up my watch, there's some writing at the base bottom here, at 6 o'clock, basically, that you, if I, it's so small and it's in a telephoto, and if you look at the sharpened one, you really see the fuzziness come out of it. It has got a slight downside. What I did notice, and I'll just, let's see if I can, I don't know, you'll probably have to go back to the video and look at this yourself. I'm going to go and have a look here at this multimeter, at the selector switch over here, and you can see in the sharpened one, I'm going to go back to the one previous which isn't sharpened, you can see there how the pixelation is kind of softened. It doesn't look too bad, but obviously the font and everything else is not as crisp. But when you go to the sharpened one, it certainly sharpens up the writing and everything else, but you do get this kind of pixely look. Now, I went for the kind of hardest sharpening I could on Sony Vegas, and I think what I might do, and you particularly notice that when you go back and look at the font, I'm going to draw this back now, and if you look at the font here, especially full screen, you really do notice the pixeling. So what I might do, I might kind of moderate the sharpening that I've done in these videos, just to try and ease up on that but still retain some crispness. So you'll have to excuse me, I still might upload one further video for my own test on my own eye to see how the medium sharpening does. But anyway, so that was my the way I went and had a look at things. And that's why I've kind of decided on 1920 by 1080p with some sharpening in the MPEG 4 format. And that's basically to kind of hopefully make things pop and give you guys some good detail in the bits and pieces that I'm doing. Now, this format and what I'm doing won't work, you know, it's what I want for the videos that I do. People will be doing, if you're not doing reviews like I am and doing other different sorts of video, then certainly something else is going to work better for you, I'm sure. It's just, this works well for my application. But certainly, if you do have any comments or things you'd like to post, then feel free and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And again, if you do enjoy the video series, or if you've gained any value out of the video, then certainly give it a thumbs up, and do share it with other people and subscribe. Thanks again for watching.